Welcome to my channel, Surprise Comics. This is Matt coming back at you with another comic book haul. We're making these a little less frequently, so they're starting to stack up. So I wanted to show you some of the stuff I've gotten recently and go from there. So these two books I'm showing you right here are Mighty Morphin Power Rangers number one. This is a Exceed Exclusives. One of my local comic shops is the exclusive store for these. You can only get them from his store or from his eBay store. And they're limited to 500 print for each cover. So I thought, why not? So I went ahead and picked it up. And I can get a little bit cheaper locally than you could over eBay. It's basically you're saving the shipping charges. But I picked them up. I thought they were pretty nice looking covers as far as all the different Mighty Morphin number one covers. When I thought these were the two best ones. And so we'll see how it goes. There's the first six issues are each getting two exclusives like this, and they're all connecting and stuff. I'm not sure if I'm gonna pick up the other ones or not. I thought I'd get this one since it was the number one, but I'll have to make a decision when they actually come out. Next up, we got Legends number three, which is the first appearance of the Modern Suicide Squad. Been looking for this book for a long time, trying to find it at a decent price. This book fluctuates big time. As you know, when the trailer drops, it'll jump up a little bit, then it'll calm down. And a huge Suicide Squad fan, you know, besides Batman, Suicide Squad's probably the main thing I collect. Now, I got most of the key Suicide Squad issues, except for like the old Brave and the Bold that came out back in the day. I think it was Brave and the Bold or Showcase, I can't remember. That one's way out of my reach, so, you know, if I was to drop that much money on a book, I'd definitely be dropping it on a key Batman issue rather than Suicide Squad. But, no, super excited to have it. Got it on eBay, late night auction, didn't cost me very much. I went to one of my local comic book stores recently, and I showed this comic book last one. I picked up another copy. This one is a normal one. My previous one was the Canadian variant. Been kind of on like, you know, I haven't been hunting for this, but I've been on the lookout for this book for a while and I never see it. And so I ended up paying a little bit more than I wanted to. And then a week later, I got this book for just a couple bucks. And so that's how it seems like how it always goes. You overpay a little bit. And then if you just waited another week, I got this for $2 or $3, or I probably paid $5 or $6 more than I should have. And it's in this condition. It's probably a $15 book or so I got. The other one I had was a variant, so it's probably a $20, $25 book, and I paid about that much for it, so can't complain too much. So this is the first appearance of Harvey Bullock, one of my favorite Batman characters. I love the Batman, to me, in the Batman world is awesome, and I love him, but what I like most about the Batman world, the Gotham world, are all the side characters, you know, Commissioner Gordon, Alfred, Harvey Bullock. Those characters I find far more fascinating, just how these normal people deal with all this crazy stuff going on. Another book I picked up for a couple bucks, Secret Warriors number two. This is a key issue if you're watching Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. This has become a key issue because one of the characters that's come on that show called Hive. This is his first appearance, and he's going to be the main villain, it looks like, going forward on that show. I won't tell you anything else about it in case you're not caught up. But this is definitely a book to look out for. I looked on eBay the day it came out, and hardly anyone even had it on there when they did. It's like they're just asking for a buck or two plus shipping. It's already tripled or quadrupled that price. People were asking $10 to $15 for this book after the episode aired last night. The comic book shop I went to, they have a dollar section. Actually, they have a whole another store that all the books are in a dollar. I go through it. Most of the time, books are kind of beat up. There's nothing too major. But I looked through this time and I found Alpha Flight number 33. This is a key issue. It's the first appearance of Lady Deathstrike. I actually picked up two copies of this and they only cost me a buck a piece. And they're in actually pretty darn good shape considering that they've been sitting in a box unbagged and unboarded probably for, you know, I think this comic came out in 80. So, you know, over 30 years it's been sitting in a box in that store, so not too bad. Another comic book shop I go to, I picked up Daredevil, the Marvel Knights number one. This is the first of the Kevin Smith run that he did. Very well received, very well done. And this cover is just an awesome, awesome cover. Yeah, so it's not like a terribly key book or anything. No, like new characters or deaths or anything. But it is kind of a, you know, it's Kevin Smith's first work with Marvel. I don't know if it's his first. I think it might be his first comic book work. I think he did this before he did his Green Arrow run. I'm actually pretty sure he did. But key issue nonetheless. They also had this issue there. The Mighty Thor, number 337. It's a little bit of a beater copy. It's, you know, it actually looks really good in the Mylar, which is like one of the appeals of Mylar. But it's, you know, probably a fine copy, but I only paid $10 for it. So not a bad price. And I also picked up the rest of that run. Here's number 338. I also got 339 and 340, which are the whole Beta Ray Bill opening story. So I'm happy to get those. Kind of those books I'm always on the lookout for and never see. I'm going to go ahead and switch it up for a little bit. My wife, who made this awesome background, she's a pretty crafty person, and she does quilting. And she does this fancy type of quilting called paper piecing. And here's one of the things she made. And this is just a bunch of small pieces of fabric sewed together kind of like in a puzzle mosaic type way to make things. And she actually designed this from scratch. You know, if you look at the back, there's, you can see all these different papers and they're labeled and stuff. She labeled all these. She sewed all these little pieces together to make these circles. And it's like a really, you know, a lot of people who sew don't like doing it because it's really challenging. And so I was really proud of how well she did on these. And she's going to make these into like a wall hanging for a nursery. Here's some of the other ones she worked on. It's a TIE fighter. Again, it's just, you know, sewn together pieces of paper, different colors. I don't know if you can really appreciate it if you don't actually see how she does it, but I thought she worked real hard on them, and I asked her if it would be all right if I showed them, and she said it would be fine. And we have the Seal of the Republic, or not the Republic, or the Rebels. She's working on the one for the Imperial. So, or the Empire. So this is a little project. I thought I'd take a second in the middle of my video to show you these before I move on. So, we hit up a Half Price Books. And I was finally able to get my hands on an X-Force number 2. It's not a hard book to find, but it seems like every time I did find a copy, you know, I've been trying to pick up this book probably for a year now. And it'd be beat up here or beat up there, and they'd be charging a little bit more than I was willing to pay for it. This is a really nice, high-grade copy. I got it for $10, which is exactly what I've been, you know, that's about the price I've been looking to pay for one in high-grade, and super excited to finally get it. The half-price books I go to usually do a pretty good job of, you know, not letting things slip through and undercharging for stuff. This time I got a little bit luckier than I usually get when I go there, and they had some nicer books, you know, actually half price. So they charge half price for the half of the cover price. Usually for a book like this, they'd be charging $8, $9 for it. I just pass on it. But this time they had it, I got it for $2.50. Secret Origin number 4, the Harley Quinn Origin. Not really worth a whole lot, but it's just a cool book, nice book to have. I got another copy of Harley Quinn number 1. It only cost me $1.50. And Harley Quinn 0 for $1.50 as well. And these are also really high grade copies. Super surprised to actually find them in a store like that, in that high of grade. Also, while I was there, I got X-23 number 4. I saw this was a really cool looking cover, so I went ahead and snatched it up because it was only, this one is actually only $1. And I also got an X-Force number 17. It looked like someone who was into X-23 just traded a bunch of stuff in, but of course any of the really high expensive issues weren't there. Thought this was a cool looking cover. You know, you got a gun or the claws, you're kind of screwed either way. And the only other key book I got there on that trip was I did get Kung Fu Fighter number 5. Paid $8 for this one. It's a little bit of a, you know, it's a mid-grade copy, but for the first appearance of Lady Shiva, who's just an awesome character there's so many villains and so many great characters, especially in the Batman world. It's hard to mix them all in, but this is definitely a character that deserves a little more attention and credit. Should be showing up more often in the books than she does. So I'm super excited to get the first appearance of Lady Shiva for a great deal. I've been to that shop several times at the Half Price Books, and they had $25 on this, and I just wasn't going to pay it for one in this condition. And then when I went in this time and I could see the sticker over the top of the old sticker, it only said $8. I'm like, heck yes. And so I picked it up. I made a couple trades recently. The first trade, basically, it was a trade with my dad. He's been, he has a massive, massive Spider-Man collection. And, you know, he has like every issue of Amazing Spider-Man, number 2, up through like, you know, the mid 400s or when it got renumbered there. And he has probably 100 of the rest of them. He's trying to kind of go in and fill up all those holes that, you know, he didn't actually stop collecting, but he just got kind of tired of paying $3, $4, $5 for a new issue. And so he finds it more fun to go and search through the dollar bins and stuff to pick up his old issues and things like that. And then every once in a while, it kind of comes back to bite him when a book, you know, goes way up and he has to pay extra. So I've been helping him out with that. I've been picking up books from the dollar bin. And so instead of rather just, you know, buying them for him, I bought them. And then I used them to trade for some of his back issues that he has, mostly Batman. I did really well, and I found more Spider-Man back issues than he had Batman. So he threw a couple extra things in. I got Nightwing half. This is one of those Wizard half issues from back in the day. Really, you know, they're not very valuable, but they're not really that, you know, you don't really find them all over the place. They always had pretty cool covers and stuff, nice little variants. And so I'm, you know, slowly working on a Nightwing run. I got, you know, a huge lot a year back, and so I decided to try to get them all to fill them in. So this is a really beater copy, but I'm super excited to have it. This is Aquaman number 29. This is the first appearance of Ocean Master, who it has been revealed is going to be the main villain in the Aquaman movie coming up in a couple years. And you can see it's been water damaged. The covers has missing color everywhere. It's, you know, but actually the, you know, the staples are rusted, but the paper quality isn't actually that bad considering all that. And, you know, it's, you know, definitely one I was excited to get. The other book, non-Batman book, I got Marvel Premiere Ant-Man. Ant-Man's like one of my favorite characters in the Marvel universe. You know, I loved Hank Pym. I loved his, you know, conflict he has within himself about being a pacifist, but also having to fight. I got the Scott Lang. I always thought was an enjoyable character. I loved the movie when it came out. I picked up 47 super cheap, and so I wanted to get 48 to go along with it, and so he had it, so we made the trade. The rest of the issues I picked up from him are all Batman issues. So we'll go ahead and go in order on those. I got Batman 249. And then I got Batman 250. And then I got Batman 252. So I'm missing the one I really want is 251. But of course, if he had that, I would have probably had enough to trade for it. But, you know, super excited to get those issues. This next issue is just a really beat up copy. Of 256, 100 page special, but you know, it's definitely a lot better shape than the, you know, one I didn't have before, so definitely would take that. You know, if I can find another better copy, inexpensive, I'll probably pick up a upgrade for that. But you know, trying to get them all, the conditions a secondary issue compared to just having them. This one I was super excited to get. This is one of the key issues. This is probably the biggest key out of the group I got from. This is Batman 258. This is the first appearance of Arkham Hospital, which later goes on to be renamed Arkham Asylum. So it's a, it's definitely a, I wouldn't say a major key, but it's definitely not a minor key either. It's a very important location as far as, different places besides the Bat Cave and Wayne Manor. I don't know if there's any other place in Gotham City that is more significant than Arkham Asylum. Got another 100-page special, 259. Got 268. And when he fights the Sheik, I'm pretty sure that's Neil Adams cover, but I can't remember for sure. This one's a little beat up, but 273. I got 389. And then I got 400. I always thought this cover was kind of goofy looking. So the book has a little bit of value. This is just a beater copy, though, so this really doesn't have very much value. Really great cast of people who worked on this book, though. It's, a who's who of artists over there. You got, John Byrne, Mike Grill, Joe Kubert, George Perez, Tim Sutton, just to name a few. But yeah, everyone on there is definitely noteworthy. And you have Stephen King wrote in it too. So, anniversary issue, pretty cool one. Next four issues are ones that I've been hunting for. And actually, I haven't really been hunting for them because I knew my dad had them. And I knew that we were going to be making a trade. So, I haven't bought these when I had the chance. But I got Batman 404. 406 and 407 in that trade with my dad. And then once I knew which ones he had, I went out later that week and I bought myself a copy of 405 to finish off the Batman Year One, which if you go back to my top 10 list for the year, I had Batman 404, which really counted for the whole one, so I can scratch that off. And so now I have 5 out of the 10. I have one other one that, 428 is going to be pretty attainable. I should be able to get the Death of the Family run or Death in the Family run. These other four, I'll be lucky to get one or two of those, but I'm definitely going to try to get all four. 232 just might be a little bit out of reach of what my budget is right now, but, maybe I'll find a deal. So super excited to have Batman Year One, parts one through four. One of the most important storylines in the history of Batman, kind of redefined him for the modern age. And then we got Batman 410, which is a key issue in the retcon Jason Todd's history following Infinite Crisis. This is one of the stories that kind of goes into one of his first adventures as Robin. We also got 411, I think the third part of that storyline, or the fourth part. And I got some Night Quest. My goal, besides getting those 10 books, is to complete the 500s of Batman, so I can have everything from 500 till the current issues. And so I'm making pretty good headway on that. I've picked up quite a few issues. Here's a few more. None of these issues are key. 504, 506, and 510. So that actually completes a little bit of a run. So now I have 492 or something up through 520, and I have a little bit of a gap. And then so I'm down to 30 issues or whatever to finish the 500s off. I'm going to a couple shows this summer. Hopefully, can find some bins that I can get them for a buck each out of there. Not have to pay a whole lot to finish off these runs because the books aren't really that valuable, but. I finished off the last two books. There's another trade I made with someone online. He's on YouTube, but he doesn't make videos. He just leaves comments stuff. His name's Joe Pop. He told me he made some deals with some other guys, so I went in and trusted him. And I had Comic Con haul a couple weeks ago. I had some really nice variant covers and multiple copies for some Wonder Woman comics, and so we went ahead and worked out a deal. I sent him a couple of my books, and he sent back Batman Europa number 4. This is a Jock variant. Very big fan of Jock. He's one of my favorite artists. you know, his work on the Detective Comic runs with Scott Snyder was awesome. Then he did Witches with Scott Snyder as well. And that was just some awesome art. Definitely a little bit darker, different style than what a lot of other people do. But just the, you know, the intensity here. Here's another example of some Scott Snyder artwork there on, you know, Detective Comics 871. There's a issue 880 that Jock did, which is really famous. Joker, his face turning into bats. Really awesome. I've been hunting for that book for ages, but it's just a pricey book. And it's hard to, I've been having issues finding it in great shape in my price range. So I've been kind of holding off on getting that one, but hopefully eventually. And the other book I got from him was Red She-Hulk number 59 variant. A super hard book to find. He sent me pictures of a bunch of books to see what I was interested in. This is a cover I'd never seen this one before. And I looked it up online and hardly anyone even has it. And so I thought it'd be a really cool book to have. So I went ahead and made that trade with him to pick this up too. So that's my haul. Thanks for watching it. I was hoping to keep this under 20 minutes, but it looks like I didn't do it. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up so I can keep as close to that as possible. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Have a good night or good morning or good afternoon whenever you're watching this.